These pictures were taken by Art Ellis, a Pittsburgh Rail fan who came to Boston for an NRHS charter from the Watertown car house to Quincy. Boston, in early March, it put into revenue service on the Watertown line its first 20 PCCs, scenes along Commonwealth Avenue inbound, headed towards the Commonwealth Avenue portal, which still exists today. This is an outbound revenue car on the Watertown line. Passing Boston University on the left. Blandford Street coming into the Commonwealth Avenue tunnel portal. At that time, the portal was covered in planking, unlike the way it exists today. A photo stop on Blue Hill Avenue at Franklin Park. In lunch hour was at Mattapan Station. Type 4 is in operation on the Mattapan-Ashmont line, the Type 4 car services line until 1952. You see the Mattapan stored cars not only for the Mattapan-Ashmont line, but also for the Mattapan-Eggleston line. Two cars were used from Watertown, number 3012 and 3017, for the fan trip. They made some round trips through the Mattapan car house complex, making photo stops, stopping for lunch. Mattapan Station, pretty much, if you look at that front part of it, is still there today on the current Mattapan-Ashmont line, which is serviced by PCC, and the last PCC line in operating in the Boston system. This fan trip was to go from Watertown Car House into the Dorchester area, Mattapan, on to Quincy and Quincy Shipyard. There was such a crowd on the fan trip, by this time they brought in a third PCC. They brought this car over from the Arborway, over Cummins Highway, and it was 3001. This was a St. Louis PCC, which the Boston Elevated Railway had bought back in 1937 as a demo, and it was the only St. Louis PCC that ever operated in the Boston system. All of the PCCs in the history of the operation were Pullman standards. The difference in this one PCC, 3001, that had no left-hand door, could not operate in the subway system. It was used primarily in revenue service when tested out on the Charles River line from Arborway, Father's Hills. From Mattapan, they traveled over the Ashmont-Mattapan high-speed line, Valley Road Station, Central Avenue Station, and a photo stop just prior to the downgrade into Cedar Grove Cemetery. Still in existence today. The three guys stopped and everybody got out for a photo stop. And here you're certainly going to see a Type 4 in revenue service coming through Cedar Grove Cemetery. At that time, the only trolley line in the United States that went through a cemetery. In the era of light rail today, there are others. Outbound from Ashmont Station to Mattapan. Type 4 was a big, monstrous, heavy-duty car that was designed to haul trailers in its day. Passing now, after the photo stop, through Cedar Grove Cemetery, to Fields Corner to Ashmont. From there, they went to Fields Corner Station by the way of Dorchester Avenue. Coming out of Fields Corner Station, this ramp still exists today, but it's for buses. It went from streetcars to trackless trolleys to bus. And you notice the two kids, which were common, hitching a ride on the back of a streetcar, which was often seen in the system throughout Boston on the Neponset Avenue. The streetcars there were serviced the line where it belonged to the Eastern Massachusetts Street Railway, stored at the Quincy Car House. here we're coming into Neponset Circle, where the operators changed. The Boston Elevator operated the cars, their territory, to Neponset Circle. The cars looped around, and the Eastern Mass operator would get on the car, and the Boston Elevator operator would get off the car. The fan trip was going to go on through into the Eastern Massachusetts territory, all the way to the Quincy Shipyard, which by this time has started a real build-up and prelude to World War II. I ran out of colored film and had to convert to black and white. This is Hancock Street coming down into Quincy. And a lot of people who saw these thought the Eastern Massachusetts were going to buy new PCC cars. These were the first PCCs ever to go into Quincy, and it picked up a lot of ice witnesses through amazement to see them there. This is the 23rd of March, 1941. Here the line, there's other trackage, but the line, all other Eastern Mass car lines had gone converted to bus. This is one of the two Eastern Mass lines that survived through World War II after to the early mid-40s, and then it was converted to bus. Here we leave Quincy Square and we're headed down Washington Street towards Fore River Shipyard. And then loop back to the Fore River Shipyard. We pulled in, there was a photo stop. There was a double track here, so revenue cars could use the outside track to bypass the PCC. Although these films are very light, they're rare footage of a very important time frame in Boston transit history. Here's the third PCC coming down into the Fore River Shipyard loop. Revenue car making the loop out of the Fore River Shipyard, Eastern Mass car, headed back to its Quincy Square and ultimately to Fields Corner Station. During the war years, the traffic on this line was so heavy that the Boston Elevator operation did augment the line with their Type 5 cars. First car you see here is the St. Louis PCC 3001, followed by the two Pullman standard PCCs. A group picture, a time-honored tradition which is still done today during fan trips. Now on the return trip, we're headed back towards Quincy Square, traveling along Washington Street. Shortly, you're going to see some vintage bus scenes. There's an HCF bus headed towards Quincy Square, more likely coming from Weymouth. Still on Washington Street between Fore River Shipyard and Quincy Square. The same bus. Not Quincy Square, an ACF. Here it comes out of Washington Street, this side of Quincy Square, now headed towards Ashmont. And this last scene is the end of, near the end of the fan trip. It's the old Jamaica car house. The trackage was in place, but the car house was abandoned. And shortly after this, after World War II started, the tracks were taken up for the war effort.